Welcome to the first video of my series on how to perform FM modulation and demodulation using the Python programming language. In this video, you are going to be introduced to the concept of encoding information within the distance between the peaks and the troughs of a sinusoid. In the second video of this series, we will visit how to utilize Python 2 and a plugin called matplotlib to make the concept become alive. Later in the series, we'll use the same tools to extract information from a sinusoid that has information encoded within its varying frequency. So without further ado, let's get a good understanding of how you can encode something within a sinusoid's frequency. The most basic way that I feel that the concept of frequency modulation can be portrayed is to have a slider with a sinusoid sitting just below it. As the position of the slider changes, the distance between the peaks of the sinusoid change as well. You could say that the sinusoid's frequency has the position of the slider encoded within it. The last topic for this video is to see how the underlying mathematics work. Let's take a look at these graphs. This graph represents the location of the slider from the previous animation at a given time. So the independent axis represents time, where the dependent axis represents the location of the slider at that given time. As for the graph to the left, this is just what our high-frequency sinusoid would look like at any given time if left alone. Now let's look at the bottom graph. Here we have a sinusoid whose frequency is dictated by what was recorded on the top left graph. Now that we have an understanding of what the three graphs are, let's take a look at the equation that makes all this possible. So it works like this. Here we have the function that was represented by this graph. This is the frequency of our carrier. Now you'll notice that by adding whatever value from this function up here to our frequency of our carrier, it will have the following effect. Let me explain. When ym, which is the position of our slider, becomes a negative value, it will actually lower the frequency of our carrier. When ym becomes positive or very positive, it will up the frequency of our carrier. Looking at the equation, that makes sense. As for the m, it is just a multiplier that allows this function to have a greater effect on the frequency of yc. Yc being just our modulated signal at the output here. And that brings us to the end of our introduction to modulation. In the next video, we're going to be taking a look at how to use the Python programming language to make these concepts that we've been looking at come alive.